Boogity! Let's go racing, boys!
All right!
Truex elected the outside. Larson may have the measure of him to lead lap one. Pretty good day in the early going for Joe Gibbs Racing. Denny Hamlin fourth. Kyle Busch led 114 laps of this race last year, finished third. How about Hamlin, Vince?
Well, they've liked it all weekend. Crew Chief Mike Wheeler told me they felt like they've just gotten a little bit better as the weekend has progressed, and they were optimistic for this run today. Denny says it's just a little tight in the center, which is prohibiting him from turning it the way he wants, but they're pretty close here in the early going, Jamie.
And Brad Keselowski just been lacking speed, qualified 25th, slipped back to 29th. But a good call on that first round of pit stops. They took right sides only, gained him a lot of track position. He restarted sixth, and now he's just kind of stalled out, running seventh right now. Said one and two has been his biggest struggle, and now he just reported to his crew chief, Paul Wolf, that the balance is exactly the same.
You know, Mike, he won the race here yesterday. Those experiences from yesterday have got to pay off for him today. He had to learn a lot yesterday for today.
Three laps left in stage one. Kevin Harvick, three quarters of a second back. That's Matt DiBenedetto in between the two leaders. First car one lap down. He moves aside. Can Harvick challenge to win stage one?
Well, there's no doubt Harvick's car is a little bit better. He's faster right now than Kyle Busch. But every time Kyle Busch puts one of those lap cars in between him, it's going to make it that much more difficult for Harvick to get to him and pass him.
Third place, Hamlin working over Larson.
Hamlin's been putting some really nice laps together here in these last five or six laps. Been watching him. He is definitely going to be a factor in this race throughout this day.
You know what's interesting? He and the 18 both run the same lap times, and they're sharing a setup, and it must be identical because they're running about the same speed around this racetrack.
Last lap of stage one. Somebody's going to get a playoff point, and 10 drivers will collect bonus points.
This is going to be fun to watch. I mean, points are on the line. These guys don't want to give up those positions.
Kyle Busch wins stage one. Harvick second, side by side for third. Hamlin wiggles, and Larson gets it.
He got a little loose up off four. And
here's
Hamlin.
Another battle. Kurt Busch for seventh on Keselowski. Was it? Didn't quite get it. That was fun to watch.
We're back under green.
Kyle Busch and Chase Elliott get a great start. It's going to be fun to watch Kevin Harvick and Kyle Busch and Chase Elliott go to battle here.
Elliott coming on the outside. Can Harvick clear him? Finally, yes, at the exit of turn four.
That was close. Really close. He squeezed right up in front of Chase Elliott right there, but it worked.
Let's go all the way back to Kyle Larson in 13th right there behind Erik Jones, Matt.
Mike, clean air was Kyle Larson's friend. It certainly isn't now. The car just continues to lean more to the free side. He's working that track bar adjuster to try to help, but it just has not improved the car any.
And Mike, I heard that over and over again in practice, and I thought a lot of guys were really worried about being loose in today. Remember, we have a very small rear spoiler on these cars now. They don't have a tremendous amount of rear downforce. You drive hard into these corners, on the brakes, you make your car loose.
Yeah, and you can't, that just shows again, you cannot afford to have anything go wrong with it. It's on a pit stop. Oh, issues with the 42 Larson.
If they're not flat here, try to
caution.
Stay out so we don't go a lap down.
Lap 121.
I don't see any tires down. It didn't look like, not on left side anyway.
He was in 13.
I can't keep it from shaking. Are they shaking?
Is that
on
those brakes again?
Or just on entry?
It depends. I mean, mostly on entry, but even when I get loose on exit, they're shaking.
I don't see any flat tires anywhere.
At Kyle Larson.
And all weekend long, he's been complaining about the brakes, getting a little wheel hot. Yeah, he just gets the left front on the apron and the car rotates and the back just comes around. Boy, that is something you never see Kyle Larson do. Yeah, well, we got a shootout here for this stage.
One lap. And we're told there is no free pass. Chris Buescher was in the free pass position. He's the car brought out the caution. One lap. For a playoff point and a stage win, green flag.
That outside lane is going to carry the momentum for Kurt Busch off of turn two and get the lead.
Yeah, he's gone. He's out of here.
Side by side for fifth.
And three wide going into turn three.
Yikes.
Further back.
Oh, what a pile this is going to be for a top 10 spot.
No kidding.
Kurt Busch wins stage two. It's on from there. He gets his second stage win of 2018. We're back to green.
Harvick's spun tires a little bit. I think this is a point in the race where Harvick would really like to make a statement if he could. If he could get by that 18, I think it'd be
big.
The three
gets loose. See, Austin Dillon got really loose getting into turn one, almost collected Eric Jones.
Truex Boyer for third. And that settles out in Boyer's favor.
Whew, quite a wad back in here. Holy smoly.
Well, we were talking to Kurt Busch about how good his car is. Another one that's in Char cars is Clint Boyer there in third position. He's been steadily making his way forward also.
Keep an eye on the lead. Here comes Harvick.
I tell you, it's just right now, it's hard to bet against that four car. I don't know about next week, but right now.
Well, listen, I like what I'm seeing out of Kyle Busch right now, how hard he's going to fight to keep this lead. We saw him slide in the back of the car when he was in front of that four, just trying to do everything he can to get the most out of that 18 car.
I think both these guys right now, Jeff, know that this is a point of the race where you got to make a statement. Can I hold him off or can I get by him?
A lapped car may help decide this. Timmy Hill is a ways ahead
the
there.
slide job.
Now, what can Kyle Busch learn from following Kevin Harvick? That's what's going to be key. Is there an adjustment that they can make on their next pit stop to get that car good enough to stay ahead of Kevin Harvick in the past and the future?
We're under caution at lap 191 in Phoenix. Paul Menard running 24th by himself. It looked like something broke on that car and it spun and backed into the wall hard at the exit of turn two.
Yeah, as we look back down the track, you'll see the car back here, the yellow car in the middle of the corner. Watch the sparks fly up under it.
Boy, you don't see an impact like that, especially on the exit of turn two here at Phoenix very often. Those sparks, I don't know if it was from the right rear tire blowing and then the wheel was where the sparks, or if something else broke in the suspension back there that caused it to cut that tire.
Yeah, I don't see the rear end housing. It looks like it's in its position it's supposed to be in. To me, it looked like a right rear tire may have gone down.
Already, Kyle Busch going to try to take advantage of Almirola on those older tires. Tell you, those two tires, they take off good. Again, that heat in the left rear and the air pressure. Nice side-by-side action for the lead. But I think they're going to take off and be pretty good for a couple laps here. It's just how long before they can hold them off with those with four tires.
And who will emerge with the lead? Byron.
The four car's kind of in a Gibbs sandwich right now. He got the 11 and the 18 all over him.
as he brings his number 18 Toyota to pit lane.
Mike, this will be a good show and tell right here. Where does the four come out compared to the 18?
Matt?
18 is in. Adam Stevens, a lot of conversation back and forth about how to try to improve this car over this run. Kyle felt like they needed to take a bigger swing this time, but the car really started to come to him at the end of that run. A little bit extra time on the left side, trying to get that left rear on. They're going to lose time, Mike.
Joey Logano is in, along with Matthew Benedetto, and Brad Keselowski is your new race leader from Ryan Newman, Eric Jones, Casey Kane, and Ricky Stenhouse.
Well, we know that they gamble, because that's how he won this race last year.
That's right.
Stayed out on tires when everybody else pitted, and it paid off.
Boy, heck of a battle going on.
Here for the lead, Keselowski Newman for the lead.
Wow, it's getting all, they're all wadded up going
and
down.
And Ryan
there.
Newman goes to the front.
For the lead, but I hate to say this, I think it's all for naught because they're going to have to pit here pretty soon.
Newman is 11 and a half up on Harvick. He was 12th before the pit stop cycle began. 24 laps to go.
And there's not a guy out there, Harvick, Bush, any of them are saying, that 31 can't make it, can he?
This right here, not for position. That's actually Joey Logano, who's a lap down in 19th.
Not a good day for not a good day for these guys. For the 22 or the 2.
11 cars on the lead lap. William Byron trying to get a lap back from Newman and does.
I think Newman might be coming to pit road here.
Ooh, be
here
careful,
comes.
Buddy.
Our fair road right here.
And Ryan Newman will surrender the lead that he's held for 22 laps. Here comes Harvick off turn 4. And as Newman rolls to a stop, we have a new leader, Kevin Harvick.
Hey, it was a hand that could have won, but unfortunately it didn't for him, for Newman. Got two tires. Out of here. They can call him what they want, but I call him the instigator because he loves to instigate things.
Well, he's long been the closer, and today, after what I thought was a great mid-race battle with Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch, three cars under a blanket, Harvick emerged from that after pit stops to drive away. In the pre-race, Kevin Harvick talked about shrugging off what happened last week.
It's just one of those situations that you look at and you build on and you go forward. And it's not the first penalty that I've had in my career. I probably got more penalties and fines in this garage than probably most of them all put together, whether it be for the car or me doing something dumb. That's part of it. It's been part of this sport for a long time. It's no different than seeing a flag in football or referee calling a penalty in the NBA. You know, sometimes you don't agree with it. Sometimes they see it one way and you see it another and you move on.
A harsh penalty, but one that likely would not have impacted the outcome of last week's race. So here comes Kevin Harvick coming to the white flag, trying to win three races in a row for the first time in his career.
Just 3 weeks of dominance. Car down in the corner, nice and smooth. Look at it, not even fighting the wheel, just kind of on cruise control, bringing her to the house.
He hadn't led a lap here in the last three races, boy. He changed that today.
Off turn 4, Happy Harvick gets his 40th career win. And his ninth in Phoenix.
How about that, boys? That's how you rebound and just show them how it is right there. Awesome job.
And victory lane, the celebration is taking place.
A double high five to the back glass. emotion and frustration's running a little high the past 4 days. What type of message, Kevin, does this pissed. Performance?
Is what I've been. I've been mad as all get out because this team does a great job. This organization does a great job. And we've got fast race cars. And to take, you know, that away from those guys just really pissed me off last week. And, you know, to come here to a racetrack that is so good for us, it's a lot of fun, and everybody was just determined this week, and we just wanted to just go stomp them. We didn't stomp them, but we won, and that's really all that matters. So I'm just proud of this team, put a fire in our belly, and just got to thank, I'm excited. Got to thank everybody from Jimmy John's, Busch, Ford, Mobile One, Outback, Hunt Brothers, Morton Buildings, Textron, Liftmaster, Haas Automation. I always forget our owners, Gene Haas and Tony Stewart, but... What a badass team right there.
Ninth win here at ISM Speedway. Historically also, you tied another Hall of Famer, Mark Martin, 40 career wins. Those type of performances mean so much to you.
Yeah, I mean, this really felt more important than winning at Homestead to race for a championship, just to drive it home for all those supporters out there and all you haters. I see you.